Hello everybody, feel warmly welcome to Usitility. Today we are on the way to see how to play Conflict of Nations WW3 on PC, now you can display it on your screen. It will be possible to simply download and set up Conflict of Nations WW3 and enjoy your game on our Windows computer with keyboard, mouse and big screen. So without further ado, let's go. First of all mates, to start we have to launch our favorite browser. We selected the one we prefer. Let's go to that URL I'm highlighting in green color. There you are seeing it on the screen of the PC. You don't need to type that URL, simply because there's the link in the description of this video and as well in the first pinned comment. We landed there on our own website of Usitility, at which we get a detailed outline on how you can download and install Conflict of Nations WW3 on laptop or computer. We scroll down a tad and simply click on the Download Game on PC button. Once we click on this link, we arrive here on the website of BlueStacks. No panic, it is simply the Android emulator that we will use to enjoy the game Conflict of Nations WW3 on our PC. As you can discover from here, we access a great deal of advantages of preferring using this emulator. Now we are ready to start downloading the Conflict of Nations WW3 by clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that you can visualize here in green. Next step is clicking on that button. And the download takes no time at all. Here it is, here is located the download. It's an executable file. What we are going to do is to run the installer, so we need to click on the file. If we are on Windows 10 it will have asked us for permission to make modifications to the device. We have clicked yes. I minimize the internet browser to find the installer better. The installer is pretty simple. It contains two possibilities, install, and setup path. I am going to explain what setup path does indeed. We basically simply click on it. So we note that we've got here the path where the emulator can be set up. If we wish to modify this directory we have got to click on that browse option, so we pick another folder and set up the emulator where we would like. I prefer to leave it as it is. I simply click on back. And I simply click install. Now, there it is. The setup commences and it will go forward with the download of these megabytes which are shown on our computer screen. At the time you save it on your hard disk, it might possibly be a bit more or less megabytes. The download speed can be faster or at a lower speed, based on your web access and depending on the velocity of the emulator web servers. Right away they're running incredibly fast. The download has been completed, and so at present it proceeds with the setup phase. The installation will need more or less time based on the strength of your machine. The more efficient it really is, the faster the software installation time and vice versa. If we merge the download and software setup phase it will take quite a while, so be patient. It has already ended for me. Now, the emulator happens to be started instantly. As you can see, down here, we have a progress bar that will move forward to the right so when it gets to the finish, the emulator is going to be started for the first time. In reality the emulator was already started, here it is for the very first time. Before we continue, as you can see now, it has made two app icons here on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks software icon will be the only one we're concerned about. Anytime we desire to start Conflict of Nations WW3 on the PC, we double mouse click on this software icon and as a result launch the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon is not related to multiplayer or even anything like that, the fact is that, it is a software icon that we would certainly never ever utilize. Let's perform the next phase, which is a must-have, and that is to access the Google Play Store. As you can discover the Google Play is started. At this point we need to log on. At this moment as soon as we're here, we must absolutely accomplish the following step that is imperative. Therefore mouse click on, sign in. Now it shows, checking info. It could from time to time get stopped at checking info, and this does not progress. If so, you could attempt to log in after a number of hours and it'll almost certainly be resolved. Now we're going to provide our email and password. The email must be a Gmail email address and its matching password. As an example you make use of the very same email address you're using at the moment in your YouTube account. Therefore I will enter my info and I will come back as soon as I have done it. That's it, details typed in. This is Google welcoming us and presenting us the terms of service. We can agree to them all by just clicking, I agree. Next, it make us possible to save to the Google Cloud. You can keep it checked and it will build a backup of your data files on that device to Google Drive. I am not going to check it, you do what you want. We click on accept. Google Play is launched without need to open it manually and instantly. To set up the app game, we need to visit the Android emulator desktop by simply clicking on the app icon indicated green colored. Right now that we are watching the desktop of that emulator, we can see that we now have here the install application button. We then click on this button. There we have got the game app. Why don't we then click here on the install button that I am displaying now in green color. And this will commence the software installation. At this moment it is going to install the video game, it usually takes quite some time or perhaps it may possibly be amazingly quickly. This all varies on the internet connection. It has by then finished setting up. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by pressing this specific button I'm highlighting in green, in order to run Conflict of Nations WW3 for the first time. Let's simply click on this My Games option just above. We are now on the emulator desktop, and we're on the way to simply click on this brand new Conflict of Nations WW3 app icon that was provided. The video game is started for the very first time. Here we have it, I can press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I will discuss the sound level of the emulator. This is here. We have the icon of higher volume and also the icon of lower volume, this way we do not use the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the music of this emulator. And to take pleasure in the experience to the maximum, we can activate the big screen, for which we have two choices. This is actually the very first one, we mouse click on that icon that I'm mentioning in green color. And the monitor is maximized, experiencing one border on top, one at the right and one at the bottom. In case we would like to run the game using all the screen, we click this game icon. And we might presently be enjoying the gameplay in full screen mode. To get out of the 100% screen functionality, just click the F11 key. And we might currently be in standard screen mode. At present, I am choosing to demonstrate you the keyboard mapping and that is actually very enjoyable. This strategy we definitely will be ready to operate the video game far more effortlessly. The first thing is to press this keyboard icon. And there you will be able to complete the necessary setups. I will leave the standard configuration, though if you plan to improve this, you can easily do this with no problem. Obviously, the emulator is entirely in our own language. From time to time it occurs that the emulator is launched in the incorrect language, as an example, in Japanese. And consequently to place it in the proper language we click here to the cogwheel. And there throughout other configuration settings, we simply click on the language drop-down. We could pick the language we like, Italian, Mandarin, and so forth. After the language is selected, we are going to save, the emulator will restart, and the game application, the next time we start it, would also be in the selected language. At this moment, there's another thing that we must take into consideration, and it is that we will receive an email indicating that a completely new electronic device has been connected with this Google account. It will certainly check with us if we're the ones who have connected that electronic device. Yes, we ought not get worried, since the emulator is emulating an Android electronic device. And to find which smartphone or tablet is being emulated, we visit here, to the cogwheel and we just click on it. Therefore we go here to the model selection. And here we learn that the emulator is emulating a Samsung cell phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all folks, so much for our tutorial. I hope that you liked it, especially that you found it informative. If that is so, bring it a superb like, subscribe to my channel, and any comments, questions or ideas, leave them in the comment field below. You may also leave a comment on my Twitch channel, I perform live streams every now and then, you have it listed below in the video description and in the very first pinned comment. Mouse click on any of the training videos that happens to be appearing on the computer screen and let's have fun again in the future training videos. Bye.